Now we will see the models related to the health. So first model is the Dunn's Wellness Illness Grid. So this model was proposed in the year 1961 by Dunn. So he mainly focused on two axes. One is the health axis and another one is the environmental axis. So in the health axis there are two corners. On the right side it is high level wellness, and on the left side it is poor health. And same way in the environmental axis there is two corners. On the top it is favorable environment, and on the bottom it is unfavorable environment. So he divided the health illness model grid as four quadrants. So in the first quadrant it is the high level wellness quadrant. So in high level wellness quadrant the person is healthy and he follows all the healthy lifestyle practices, and he is also able to have the accessible environment to healthcare and also family members supporting them. So when the person follows the health practices and he is having a good environment where he is able to get the medical treatment and also family members who are supporting the patient, then we call the person as having high level wellness. And next comes the second quadrant, that is emergent high level wellness. In emergent high level wellness, in this quadrant the person follows the person knows about all the healthy lifestyle practices, but due to certain circumstances he is not able to follow them due to some unfavorable environment. This can be any job stress or lack of support from the family members, or there is no access to medical care. So these are certain things which can make the person to lose the high level wellness. So when a person knows what is the healthy lifestyle practices but cannot follow the lifestyle practices due to some unfavorable environment like lack of support or no access to medical care, then the person is in need of emergent high level wellness. And the next quadrant comes the protected poor health. In protected poor health the person is already ill. Okay, so the poor health is the person is already ill but he has a favorable environment. That means he has access to medical care and support from family members. So when the person is in favorable environment but has poor health, then he is protected because the environment is good. He can get medical treatment and then he can improve the health. And finally the last quadrant is the poor health. So in poor health the person is having illness and also he is in the unfavorable environment. That means he doesn't follow any healthy lifestyle practices and he also doesn't have any access to the healthcare, then we call the person as poor health. So these are the four quadrants given by the Dunn's wellness illness grid. So in high level wellness, that means for example a person who is healthy with all good lifestyle practices and he also having access to medical care and is able to maintain the health, we call them high level wellness. And emergent high level wellness is a person who is know about the health life lifestyle, healthy lifestyle practices, but is not able to follow them due to so many stress, tensions, or some lack of care, lack of support from family members, then he is in emergent high level wellness, and protected poor health is already the person is not in a proper health, and he is having good access to the medical care and support from family, so his health can be protected. And poor health means he is in a illness and also doesn't have a good access to health care or support from family members, that is lack of nutrition or lack of education, lack of medical care. So all these things will make the person to go into poor health. This grid is given by the Dunn's wellness illness grid. Okay, next, the another health illness continuum model was given by Travis. Okay, so this is health and illness continuum. This was proposed by John Travis in the year 1972. So he also gave a model. So in this model, Travis proposed that the person is a human being is in a neutral condition. So neutral is where there is no diseases. So the person, if you progress to the right side, he will go to the high level wellness. If a person, neutral person, when he progress to the left side, he can go into a premature death. So when a person goes to the right side, it is high level wellness. On the left side, it is the premature death. And this is the wellness paradigm. So there are two paradigms. One is wellness paradigm, means he is moving towards the right side, and the other is the treatment paradigm, which is in the left side. So in Travis model, he says that a human being who is in neutral, that means there is no disease and he is a normal person. So when a person, he is aware about the, that is awareness about the health related aspects, and he is getting education related to the health, and he is able to grow in that education. So when he is aware about his health condition, and when he has some problem, he gets education related to the health, and when he gets the education, he follows all the healthy lifestyle practices, that is called growing in the health, then he goes into the high level wellness. On the other hand, if the person is not following, then he may develop signs. Signs are objective, that means what we observe on the patient. For example, a person is coming with a fever, then we check the body temperature either by a thermometer or by touching with our hand, then we know the person body is warm, then it is called the sign. Signs are what we observe on the person. And when the signs develop later, they go into symptoms. So symptoms is subjective, that means what the patient complains. So patient may complain that he has pain, that he has fever, that he has palpitations. So like that, patient will have so many complaints. So when the person is developing the signs and symptoms, if he is going to a medical care or healthcare, and he can, if he gets knowledge about the disease, he is treating the disease and and growing, that means he is able to follow the health related practices, then he will go to the right side, that is wellness paradigm. On the other hand, if he have, even after getting signs and symptoms, if he neglects his health, he may go into disability. Disability is some chronic disease where he may lose his activity of daily living. So this disability, if it further worsens, then it can result in a premature death. This is the model given by Travis health illness continuum. So this is the two paradigm. Wellness paradigm will lead to high level wellness.